SQL Server comes with a very powerful administrative and development environment called SQL Server Management Studio, or SSMS. Microsoft offers free and paid versions of SQL Server, but SSMS environment is always free and can be downloaded from Microsoft website. We recommend you to download the latest release of SSMS, currently 18.4, even if you have to connect to the older versions of SQL Server. Microsoft does a good job keeping the backward compatibility of SSMS to previous versions of SQL Server. I'd also like to point out that SQL Server and SQL Server Management Studio are different products. SSMS is a tool that can be used to connect to SQL Server, perform administrative tasks, and write SQL queries. You can write SQL queries without connecting to SQL Server, but cannot execute them, and most features will also be unavailable. That is why the first thing you see after launching SQL Server Management Studio is the connection window. SSMS has several areas that can maintain connections to SQL Servers. The Start window establishes connection for Object Explorer. To do that, you need to enter the parameters of the server that you want to connect to. In the Server Type drop-down, choose Database Engine to connect to SQL Server Database Server. Then you have to enter server name. It consists of two parts. The server address, can be hostname or IP address, and the instance name. Note that SQL Server can be installed as a named instance or as a default instance. Several named instances can be installed on one machine. They will all have the same address, but different instance names. That is why connecting to named instance required instance name. A connection cannot be established without it. Valid server names are Moon01, SQL Server on local network on the machine named Moon01, a default instance. 192.168.0.51/dev, which is a SQL Server with named instance dev. Same IP address /test, which is a SQL Server with named instance test. mytestasiadatabase.database.windows.net. That is a SQL Server hosted in the Internet, a default instance. After you have entered server type and server name, you need to choose authentication method. If you choose Windows authentication, you don't need to enter anything, as you will be logged in with your current Windows account credentials. And in case of SQL Server authentication, you will have to provide the login name and password that you have received from the server administrator, and let's hope it's not SASA, which used to be a default master account and password in early versions of SQL Server. Never use this combination. Use secure passwords and password management tools like KeePass to store them. The basic settings for your connection are now configured, and you can connect to your server. However, if you need to set up additional parameters, click Options button. Under Connection parameters, you can specify the database that should be accessed. If you leave default, SSMS will establish the connection to default database, specified in your SQL Server account. Some SQL Server administrators limit the protocols that can be used to access a server. If you have specific instructions from your system administrator on the protocol type that should be used, you can change it under Network parameters. We will not dig into details for now, just note that additional connection parameters can be used to tweak connections properties. You can use text-based property value entries to override or extend settings from other pages of this dialog. For example, you can set timeout value, override default database name, or use alternative username. Now that configuration is complete, I click Connect and SSMS connects Object Explorer to the specified server and displays its node. Object Explorer is a tree-like control that can connect to multiple SQL servers and display their databases, users, and other objects. You can do a lot of stuff here using context menus of object nodes. For example, create new databases, users, change database properties, or restore backups. To create a new query window, right-click any database node and select New Query. You can switch between databases on different servers using standard connection switch drop-down. Unfortunately, SSMS is not perfect when it comes to connections management. you can check our video about advanced connections management in SSMS that we have prepared. For further details about using SQL Query Editor and running queries, check out our next video from this series. That is all for today. Thumbs up if you like the video and don't forget to share your feedback in the comments below to help us improve this functionality. Thank you for watching and we'll see you next time.